Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can use the new Toon layer in order to create something like the robot that you can see here. This is a really nice effect because it looks a little bit like a hand drum, but at the same time it has like all of this interesting noise and kind of like mechanical type of lighting on it. So we will see how we can create this using the Toon layer and also the new outline layer in combination. All right, let's begin. Alright, so for my scene, I have this robot here and I also have this sphere, and they are both using a very simple material that is called a toon. I also have a floor that is using a simple material that is slightly blue and a lighting layer that is on overlay. And for my light, I have 0.8 of intensity and I also have a slightly orange color. Alright, so what I want to do is that I want to create a new layer here and then I want to switch back to Toon. And let's see what parameters do we have. So the main parameter here is this one that is called gradient. And if I start changing it, you can see directly on the viewport how it's affecting the shading of this object. So by default, this gradient is pointing to a position, and that position right now is the camera, which means that if I move, it's going to react to my camera movement. If I change it to lights, for example, it's going to point to the position of the light. So now if I move my light, you can see that it's going to move following my light. So I want to start like changing a little bit this gradient so it feels more like some sort of cartoon or anime style. For that, what I want is that I want to pull this first step into here, and then I want to move this one to here. I want to move this one to here and this one to here. So something like this. So you can see I'm basically creating three colors here. So this gives me this interesting effect here. What we want is that we want the middle color to be something like a little bluish. So I'm going to be using the blue color here. And then I'm going to copy maybe something like this. And then I'm going to copy this color in here. And now for the bright color, we want something that is like a red color, something like this. And for the shadows, it's gonna be just black, so we're good in that sense. If I start increasing the noise here, you will see that things start to look more interesting, right? You can go very wild and then you can get something like this, but that's not ideal. So for now, I'm just going to use 0.31, which is a good parameter. That's good enough for what we want to achieve right now. So I also want to show you a couple of other options that we have here in the Toon shader. So for example, we can increase the opacity of the shadows, which means that now we will be seeing actual projected shadows inside the object. So if you move these, you can see how the shadows are basically being projected there. We can actually control like the intensity of this effect and even the colors, for example, that is more like a white color or maybe something like yellow. I'm just going to put it on zero because we don't want that at this moment. Let me just reset everything here because we don't need the shadows. We can have an outline layer here, for example. And now you can see that this looks more close to our initial vision. What I want is that I want to use the overlay, and this is gonna give me this red color here and a slightly darker color on the blues. And now I want to duplicate these. And in the new one, I want to use a normal and I want to make this slightly smaller. So maybe this could be something like 0.8. And another thing that I want to do is I want to change the threshold so this does not happen always. Maybe something like this. And you can see that in some areas here, the black is not there. It's only just the red color. So that's kind of like what we were looking at the beginning. That's how you can build this effect on Spline using the Toon layer and the outline layer. I hope you like this tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye bye.